Good evening, friends. Dr. Meenakshi Sauhta again, connecting with you on Facebook Live as always on every Thursday. And today also, I would like to speak to you on a requested topic by my audience. They had requested me to speak on postpartum depression, or depression which usually happens to a lady immediately after delivery. So, I thought let me take up this topic. Now, the most important thing for postpartum depression is to know that there is an entity like postpartum depression. Everybody should be aware of this. So, not only the patient who is pregnant, but her family also should be aware that there is something like postpartum depression, which usually is seen immediately after delivery or any time up to 1 year after the childbirth. Women who have depression, history of depression prior to a pregnancy, are more susceptible, but it can happen to anybody. It can happen to any woman, even if she has no history of depression in her family or in herself. So, as we see, actually pregnancy and childbirth is a very stressful condition for the woman, especially in today's world where they are working women. They have pressures from home, pressures from family, pressures from work and everything, and all put together, and along with that a pregnancy and a childbirth sometimes becomes very difficult to handle. So, we have to understand that immediately after delivery, a woman needs all the support that she can get from family, from every possible person who is around her. The hormones that have, you know, created a havoc in her body during pregnancy are now receding. So, the receding hormones actually take a toll on her, and along with that, she is, you know, saddled, or she's been given a little baby who she does not know what to do about. She's not trained to look after that baby. All the reading in the world, all the counseling, all the classes do not actually prepare you for what is going to happen when the baby actually comes into your life. So, she's not prepared for what she is going to face. Sleepless nights, difficulty with breastfeeding, you know, family all around, friends all around, everyone with a new kind of advice and counseling, wise advice I would say, and she's totally confused and in a total mess. And on top of that, people visiting and you know, not allowing her to sleep, her own sleep cycle which is totally disrupted and disturbed, the pain of the childbirth, whether it is in the form of the episiotomy or in the form of a cesarean. And of course, you know, don't eat this, don't eat that, don't do this, don't do that, doctor's advice, doctor's visits, baby's immunization, baby's having jaundice, caring for the baby. It's a completely new world. It's a completely new world. All the attention now has, you know, focused away from her to the baby. So, everyone is fussing about the baby and nobody is actually looking at that poor lady, the poor mother, who is actually going through. Everybody just expects her to know it all and do it all, which is very, very sort of, you know, difficult for her to handle. So, postpartum depression may hit a woman at any time. Some women, it starts manifesting immediately after a childbirth. So, as soon as the baby is born, the next day when the doctor goes on rounds, I immediately see that lady, you know, figure out, besides the general examination, ki bleeding hai ki nahi, pain hai ki nahi, khana khaya ki nahi, walk kiya ki nahi, urine pass kiya ki nahi. I generally try to talk to her and try to get a feel of how she is feeling. And you know, a patient who's started having this postpartum depression will feel distant. She will feel disconnected from the family, from the baby. She won't want to look at the baby. She will not make eye contact with you. You try to talk to her and she will tell you her complaints very vaguely. She won't be too complaining also. She will say, I'm all right. She won't allow you to examine her so easily. She will be trying to hide under her blanket, not, you know, generally trying to interact with everybody. When you ask her about breastfeeding, she will be distant. She will not give you direct answers. So you can, you know, see that something has, you know, broken or something has set in. The family usually doesn't realize this. They think she's tired or she's, you know, exhausted. And there is a mother-in-law sitting or a mother sitting or a sister sitting who's trying to talk to her. Everybody is talking among themselves and chattering among themselves and talking about the baby and their experiences. But this lady will be, you know, lying down or sitting in one corner, looking out of the window, looking the other way, you know, not really trying to connect with anything. So that is the first sign that you pick up that she may be actually going into postpartum depression. And if you can pick her symptoms up at that time, that is the time you actually need to start her on some anti-anxiety drug, or you need to get her to have some counseling so that it does not worsen. So postpartum depression may be mild, it may be moderate, or it may be very severe. In very severe cases, we actually see the mother completely rejecting the baby. She doesn't want to pick up the baby, she does not want to feed the baby. She may have suicidal tendencies herself. She may be talking about, you know, suicide herself. She may be, you know, wanting to do something or harm the baby. So in that situation, the relatives actually don't understand what is going on, and they come back to you and say, you know, she's a bad mother. She doesn't want to look after the baby. And, you know, the doctor also probably in a hurry may feel that maybe she's, you know, got a female child, or she's not prepared for this childbirth, or, you know, that is why she's, you know, kind of behaving like that. But no, you should be very aware. The family also should be very alert and very aware about these symptoms. And the doctor also should be very alert and aware when the relatives come and give you hints like, you know, she's not feeding properly, she's sleeping too much, she's crying all the time. We don't say anything to her, still she's all the time very upset. So, you know, pick up these symptoms. These are the women who actually need help and need counseling, and sometimes may need even medication for a while to be able to tide over these symptoms. So if you, when a patient walks into your OPD for a postpartum visit or a post delivery visit, take time not only to examine her, or, you know, just see her stitches, see her breast, see her baby, and, you know, tell her, write a few medicines and send her away, but try to talk to her. Try to talk to her away from the family and try to see and assess how she's feeling. You are the one, as a doctor, I am the one who can pick up a postpartum depression very easily. But after I pick up a postpartum depression, what I do is more important. Because when I pick up a postpartum depression, I don't need to just counsel the husband or the family and tell them that, look, she's going into depression, watch over her, take care of her. Of course, I need to do all that. But I need to tell them that, look, this is a problem. This may get worse. This may need medication. She needs to see a counselor. Believe me, there is nothing wrong if I say that you need to see a counselor. Every person in their life undergoes some kind of stresses, some kind of problem, some kind of depression for which you may need help, and it is not wrong to take. Ab ek appendicitis hota hai, you go to a surgeon to get it removed na. If you have a gynae problem, you go to a gynae doctor to get it removed na. So this is a problem with your psyche. You need help. You may need to go to a doctor, and there is nothing wrong in that. That does not label you as, you know, a pagal or a crazy person. No. You are a normal, sane person who is undergoing a stressful experience in your life, and you just need help to tide over it. Maybe you never need to see a psychologist again or a counselor again. But this is the time, if you need it, please go and seek help. Ask for help. So if I, as a doctor, have picked up a postpartum depression and advised counseling, the family or the lady should not feel bad. They should accept that, yes, this is a problem. And if they don't do it immediately, it may get worse. And if it gets worse, then it gets really bad. Then it might require hospitalization. It might require the mother and the baby to be kept separate. It might require the mother to stop breastfeeding because of the drugs that she's on. It might require very long-term medication. So be aware. The first thing that I tell all my people who are listening to me is, be aware that a mother may have postpartum depression. She may need help. she may need counseling. Give her all the support, give her all the help. Don't label her as a bad mother or a crazy person. Please see, bring her to the doctor. Let the doctor pick up these symptoms, these signs, and send her to the specialist who can handle all these problems for her. It is not wrong to have postpartum depression. It is not your fault. It is not anybody's fault. It is just an entity, a problem which may come up after delivery, which is usually neglected and ignored. So I just hope that I have spoken enough on this, and you know, you have understood what I'm trying to say. So if you see your friend or your relative or your daughter-in-law or your daughter or your sister who is having these kind of symptoms, seek help. That is all I want to say. I am really glad that everybody actually saw the videos and has put up topics that I needed to discuss, because it makes it easier for me, you know, to think. Otherwise I have to only think ki ab mujhe kya bolna hai next Friday or next Thursday on a Facebook live. I'll be really happy if you have more questions. If you want me to talk about more topics, please come with your queries, and I'm sure we'll pick them up and discuss them next time when we do the Facebook live. I hope you enjoyed this session today. It was all gyan, unlike the last time where I just spoke all general things. And see you again on next Thursday. Thank you so much.